Students, in today's session, I'm going to discuss trick to solve hyperconjugation questions easily. This topic is from General Organic Chemistry, in short, GOC. Electronic effects are of four types: inductive effect, mesomeric effect or resonance effect, hyperconjugation and electromeric effect. Inductive effect, mesomeric, resonance, I already uploaded the videos. In today's session, I am going to discuss about hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation is possible in carbocation, alkenes and in free radicals. The main condition to exhibit hyperconjugation is sp3 hybridized carbon should be connected with carbocation, or sp3 hybridized carbon should be connected with alkene, or sp3 hybridized carbon should be connected with free radicals. This sp3 hybridized carbon, it should have at least one alpha hydrogen, then only it exhibits hyperconjugation. See here, carbocation means carbon having positive charge. It should be connected with sp3 hybridized carbon. It should have one alpha hydrogen. Clear? Alkene means double bonded carbon. It should be connected with sp3 hybridized carbon. It should have at least one hydrogen. It shows hyperconjugation. Clear, students? Here, free radical means carbon with single electron or unpaired electron. It should be connected with sp3 hybridized carbon. It should have at least one alpha hydrogen. What is alpha hydrogen? Next to this carbon is called alpha carbon, and the hydrogens present on that is called as alpha hydrogens. To this double bonded carbon, this carbon is called as alpha and the hydrogens are alpha hydrogens. This is alpha carbon, alpha hydrogens. Just I will fill with hydrogens. Carbon valence is 4, already 2 is there. Next I'll write 2 hydrogens. Here just I fill with hydrogens, 1, 2, 3 bonds, one more bond I'll put, because carbon valence is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us see first carbocations, then alkenes and free radicals. Practice the questions which I am going to do now, and the easy methodology I am going to apply in your and solve your question banks or study materials, whatever gives in your college. Definitely you are going to do in a less time and with and you are going to score more marks in your exams. Let us start first with carbocations. Hyperconjugation in carbocation. Take this example. Here what happens is sp3 hybridized carbon, this hydrogen, whatever the hydrogen is there on sp3 hybridized carbon or alpha carbon, these electrons are called sigma electrons, and this sigma electron shifts here. This sigma electron shifts here, then hydrogen CH and here CH2, these two electrons shifts here so that hydrogen gets positive charge, and here already single bond is there, one and one more bond, double bond will form. Same way, if this hydrogen involves in resonance, means here this hydrogen is in conjugation with the, what to say, these electrons, sigma electrons are in conjugation with the carbocation. So it involves in the resonance and we get the structure like this, H, C, and this is same as it is, and these two electrons involves in conjugation, not here, here, then what you get? H plus double bond CH2. If this hydrogen involves, then we get H plus C, H, here H, double bond CH2. In this way, we get different structures. These three structures are called hyperconjugative structures due to CH bond. Hyperconjugative structures due to CH means alpha hydrogens. How many alpha hydrogens are there, students, here? 1, 2, 3. 3 alpha hydrogens. So how many hyperconjugative structures are possible due to these alpha hydrogens? 3. Total number of structures is alpha plus 1, total 4. And due to CH bond, if they ask you in the question, then it will be 3. And in the same way, alkene also I discuss here. After that, I discuss free radical. Then I am going to do the excellent questions on this hyperconjugation. Take this alkene. This is the double bonded carbon. The next carbon is alpha and these hydrogens are alpha hydrogens. These sigma electrons are in conjugation with this pi. Then these two shifts here. These two electrons shifts to this carbon. Then what is the structure we get, students? C, H and here hydrogen. These two electrons shifts here so that it gets positive charge. And whenever these electrons shifts, it forms a pi bond here, CH. This pi electron shifts here, then CH2 minus. Same way, if this hydrogen involves, we get the structure if 1, 2, 3, third hydrogen, if this hydrogen involves, then we get this structure. In this way, total 4 structures we get, and due to alpha hydrogens, how many structures? 3 structures. Let us do for free radicals. What is a free radical? Carbon with a single electron is called free radical. If this alpha hydrogen involves here, what is the structure we get, students? H plus, and here one hydrogen, double bond, CH2. If this hydrogen involves, then we get here we get free radical, because these two electrons shifts, or if this bond break, here one radical combines, we get the bond. So here also free radical, and if it involves this hydrogen, it get one free radical, and here hydrogen, double bond, CH2. This is the way to draw the hyperconjugative structures. Right, now I am going to do the questions. CH3 plus, then CH3, CH. Yes, in this 4, which is having more stability? Just the easiest method is, I'll tell you, easiest thing is, more is the number of alpha hydrogens. Just count the alpha hydrogens. More is the alpha hydrogens. Then more will be the hyperconjugative structures. Then more will be the stability. Any structure, first what you have to do? You have to count the number of alpha hydrogens. Then it will be having more stability. In this 4, this is one alpha carbon, alpha carbon, alpha carbon. It is having 3, 3, 3. Total 9 alpha hydrogens here 3 plus 3, 6 alpha hydrogens. In this case, 3 alpha hydrogens. In this case, how many it is having? 3? No, this is a carbocation. It should have sp3 carbon. It is not having any sp3, so 0 alpha hydrogens, no alpha hydrogens. So what is the correct stability order? 1 is greater than, 2 is greater than 3. Let us see the next question. In this 3, which is having more stability? Just go through it. This is tertiary, secondary, primary carbocation. Tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary, than primary. Same way do here also. This carbon is connected to how many carbon, students? 2. So it is secondary carbocation. Here this carbocation is connected to only one carbon, primary carbocation. Here this carbon is connected to 1, 2, 3. 3 carbocations, so tertiary. Just count the hydrogens, or do in this way, you get the right answer. Tertiary is more stable than secondary, than primary. So structure 3 is more stable than structure 1, than structure 2. This is the correct order. This is the stability order as per hyperconjugation. Deuterium and hydrogen. Listen carefully. Deuterium and hydrogen. Deuterium is having more plus I effect than hydrogen. This is important, students, because here the students do the mistake. And So whenever deuterium is having more electron releasing power than hydrogen, then tell me CD3 and CH3, which will be having more releasing group, axis releasing group, plus size CD3. But according to hyperconjugation, CD3 and CH3 is a stable group than CD3 because CD bond is a strong bond. It has a high bond dissociation energy, so that it won't involve more in hyperconjugation when compared to the CH3. CH3 involves in hyperconjugation more and it is more stable. And one more trick I want to give you here while solving the questions. Whenever inductive effect and hyperconjugation is there, you have to give priority to hyperconjugation. When inductive effect only there, then inductive effect. If inductive effect and hyperconjugation both are there, then give priority to the hyperconjugation. Let us see some questions. Carbon with the three hydrogens. This is the carbocation. And carbon with three deuteriums. Tell me which one is more stable. Here deuterium is a releasing group when compared to hydrogen, so that it stabilizes this carbocation and more will be the stability. This is due to inductive effect plus psi, because here no hyperconjugation. Suppose if hyperconjugation is possible in the structure, how you will identify whether hyperconjugation or inductive effect? The carbocation should be connected to sp3. It should have an alpha hydrogen, then it shows hyperconjugation. See this question. CH3 CH2 plus and CD3 CH2 plus. If you do according to hyperconjugation, this is a more plus psi group than this, so it exhibits, it is more stable, but hyperconjugation dominates. In this, three alpha hydrogens are there, here no alpha hydrogens, so first one is more stable than the second one. And one more question. In this four, which is having more stability? Give me the stability order. What you have to do? Just count the alpha hydrogens. Even though CD3 is there, it is having more plus psi when compared to CH3. You should not consider. Why, students? Because here hyperconjugation is dominating factor than the inductive effect. Here how many alpha hydrogens are there? 9. And here 6. Here 3. No alpha hydrogens. So one is more stable than, more is a hyperconjugative structures, because more is a alpha hydrogens, more hyperconjugative structures. One is greater than, two is greater than, three. In the question, if they ask how many number of hyperconjugative structures are possible, due to alpha hydrogens means only 9, total number means 9 plus 1, 10. And do this question. See here. In this two, which is more stable? CH3 or CD3 is having, just to see here, CD3 according to plus psi, you can say that it is a releasing group, so that it stabilizes the carbocation and it will be more stable. But here resonance is, hyperconjugation is possible, because here whatever the carbon is there, sp3 carbon, it is in conjugation with the pi bond, so that this CH3, it is in the structure, three alpha hydrogens are there, here no alpha hydrogens, so structure one is more stable than structure 2. And see the condition, whether deuterium is there. If it is inductive effect, it is more dominative. Only inductive effect, give priority to deuterium. And if it is hyperconjugation, then give priority to CH3 group. Questions on alkene I'm going to do now. Just try this. In this four, which one is more stable? To this double bonded carbon, how many alpha hydrogens are there? No alpha hydrogens. Here, to this double bonded carbon, three alpha hydrogens are there. Here, to the double bonded carbon, six alpha hydrogens are there. To the double bonded carbon, 3, 3, 6, and 3, 9. Total 9 alpha hydrogens are there. More is the alpha hydrogens, more is the stability. So this is the stability order. Let me do for carbo free radicals. Free radicals also you can do, and in the same way as that of the which one? Carbocations. in this three, which one is having more stability, students? This is which free radical? This free radical is connected to three carbons, means this is tertiary free radical. Here free radical is connected to only one carbon, primary free radical, and here it is connected to two and it is secondary free radical. Count the alpha hydrogens, you can get the same way as I am doing. Tertiary free radical is more stable than secondary, than primary. So which structure is more stable in this three? First one, next three, next two. Now I am going to give you test yourself question. Which of the following has maximum number of hyperconjugative structures? First one, isopropyl carbonium ion, tertiary butyl carbonium ion, n-propyl carbonium ion and benzyl carbonium ion. I am giving more questions because these topics are very important. Try this and this also. Give me the stability order. Maybe you are going to do the mistakes in these two. Do carefully. I am going to give the solution in the description box. Thanks for watching.